9:37, what did it say in your Bible? In Matthew 9:37, this is what it says. It said the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. God is saying there's so much work to be done, but we don't have enough people to get it done. And I have to say this because I'm the pastor. When you've been given, and Dr. King is dead and gone, and nobody else has walked in his footsteps since. He said, whatever you do, be the best at what you do. Even if you're a street sweeper, be the best street sweeper that heaven and earth and the devil and hell, nobody can stop you from being the best you can be. But we must understand that in this, what God is saying, the harvest is plenteous, but the laborers are few. And what did it say in Matthew 9:38? Here's key to it. What is it in Matthew 9:38? Somebody hadn't even turned back. In Matthew 9:38, I'm going to wait on you to turn back because I just want to teach this. In Matthew 9:38, Matthew 9, what did it say? Thank you, Sister Glenn. Thank you, bro. It said, if you want the church to grow, is that not what the word is saying? If you want an increase in the church, if you want an increase within the body, don't complain about this, don't complain about that. If you want an increase, God said, pray and tell God to send some people that's going to take care of responsibility. In light of the world, and then I went to Jamaica and I taught the same class. And I used the same scripture. If you want things to be done, you got to pray and ask God to send people that's going to take care of responsibility. And so you can't just pray and say, God, send somebody, because God will send you anybody and they'll call for help and take care of you. Well, yeah, well, so you gotta pray and ask God to send people that is responsible. People that's gonna take care of responsibility. So here's the answer. In 2017, when you pray, ask God to send laborers into the vineyard that's going to be responsible to carry out his work. I want to tell you something, church. I don't care what we do in life. Only what we do for God is going to last. Nothing else you do, nothing else you say, ain't gonna matter. Only what you are doing for God is the only thing that matters in God's sight. Thank you. Responsibility. And in Proverbs 6:9, turn back there. Teach me security. Here's the problem. Look at somebody and say, there's a problem. Proverbs 6:9. It says some people have been asleep too long. And when you sleep, it keep you from doing things. Without some changes, some things remain the same because people are asleep on the inside. And somebody, the preacher, the wife, the husband, the grandmother, the daughter, the niece, the nephew, the uncle, somebody need to tell somebody it's time to wake up. Too much sleep. is going on among God's people. Now, what is the essence? Now, I want you to understand the revelation. Now, listen, why did you come to Bible study? I want you to understand the revelation. It's not saying that you are physically sick. I hope that parade here up and sit down. I want you to understand it's not talking about physical sleep. It's talking about spiritual sleep. Because anytime you are not taking care of your responsibility, you are sleep. And God is saying, somebody need to wake up somebody and tell them, you've been sleeping too long. Things are going wrong. Things are moving forward because you are not taking care of your responsibility. Peace, Bishop. Now, these messages are not popular, but they're powerful. And you should never want to live the rest of your life being satisfied with where you are. We talk about things will get greater, things will get better. Things will not get greater and better until you start taking care of your responsibility.
Sacrifice, and they'll stay away for a while, but you wait a little while longer.
going to send you home thinking about responsibility. Because Frank and I was talking in my office about our children. I said, whether we were with them or not with them, we still took care of our responsibility. And what makes a man, what makes a woman, is taking care of your responsibility. All right. What makes a strong Christian, not how pretty you look, not how handsome you dress, but it's the responsibility of the action. If you look at the word responsibility, the first part of that word is response. You have to respond to the responsibility that's given. If you don't respond to responsibility that's given, you are going through the motions of Christianity. But you are not really a Christian. Because Christianity is to be Christ's life and do what Christ has called us to do. Let me say this. I'm going to finish. The Bible says, you can say you have faith all day long. But if faith don't have any works, God said, you have done nothing. Am I not teaching the word here? So your faith is dead if your action does not support your faith. Thanksgiving. My faith said, give out food to the homeless. I didn't want to be somebody that talked about it. I wanted to be about it. This week I said, you know what, God? Since I fed the hungry and I walked the streets and got home at 12 midnight, almost 1 o'clock in the morning, I said, you know what we're going to do for Christmas? I said, we're going to give a gift to every Dorville police officer. And maybe it was announcing announcements. I said, call chief of police and tell them the Zion Full Gospel want to bless the police officers. Because all police officers are not bad. And you don't get in trouble. You know the first person you're going to call is 911. And you need to understand, no matter what goes on, if you bless somebody, God will turn around and he'll bless you. My secretary got on the phone, called the chief of police, sent word to tell Christian Buren that's a wonderful thing that he's doing. So I just don't want to be a church to say we have church. I want to be the community church. I want to be the state church. I want to be the pastor to everybody. State representative Sharon Beasley team called me up on the phone. She said, Bishop Buren, I got some good news I need to tell her. And I gave Daddy the phone number. I said, you talk to her. And she would tell him what the good news was. But whatever the good news is, it's got to do with Zion. So I'm going to tell, don't live your life thinking only about you. Live your life thinking about somebody else. Responsibility is the key to your success. And responsibility, you may not be rich, you may not have everything, but if you're a man or woman of responsibility, you're the richest person in the world.